All right. We have two circles. One is bigger than the other one. Okay. You know what? I just give you a radius on this one. Okay, this radius is 7 inches. How about that? Okay, this one, 5 inches. Uh-huh. So, I can label this one. Okay, 7 inches. This one is a 5 inches. Uh-huh. Then, we put this one together like this one. So, one meeting point we call tangent circles, right? Tangent means touch it just one time. That's it. Okay, not twice to remember. Now, that's why if we have a circle, okay, some kind of a line, just touch it one time, that's what we call tangent line, okay? So if this one go through, okay, so through like this, that's a secant line, okay? So that means, say again, this is tangent, tangent, okay? Tang means touch, okay, tangible property. Tangible means touchable, right? You can touch the property. Okay, this one is a secant. Okay, secant. Okay, secant line, tangent line. Please remember this. Also, we have to understand, okay, this tangent line for this circle and this circle both, that's why we call it common. See? Okay, common tangent line. Okay. So now, we are looking for the distance of this tangent line. That's it. Common tangent line. Alright? So, hey, let's say this one is X then. Okay, from here to that point right there. How are you gonna get it? Okay, think about it. I give you 2 seconds. Okay, in this case, so we can apply some kind of additional line. Okay. This radius is right here, so no reason to be here. That's why I gotta move this radius right there. Alright, see? Okay, then this one and this one, obviously 90 degrees, right? Okay, you know that. This one also, see? This one gonna be right there. This one also 90 degrees. Fantastic! Wow, then, one more line. Okay, what is the distance? Okay, center to center. Okay, that's it. This one is a 5, this one is a 7 together, right? Okay, let's say, okay, this one, I label this one, okay? So this one is a 5, okay? This one is a 7 inches, so together 12 inches, right? Now, what else can you see? Oh, man, okay. See, from here, you can make another line just like this. Okay, just like that. So, I made a rectangle right there. So, this one obviously, okay, so right angle. So, that small, thin, long triangle is what? Right triangle. Ooh, wait a minute. Something is going on here, right? That's right. We gotta use Pythagorean theorem. Okay. This is the triangle. This one was 7, this one was 5. So what is 7 minus 5? 2, right? This is 2 inches. Alright. So I label this one 2 inches. Now, what about this one then? That long. Oh, that's a hypotenuse, right? Which is 7 and 5 together 12. 12 inches and 2 inches. We are looking for what? This is it. Alright, x inches. Alright, Pythagorean theorem. X equals, okay, square root. Alright, very easy. 12 squared minus 2 squared. That's it. Alright, so which is 144 minus 4, 140. Fantastic. Okay, 140. So, equals. Yeah, 140 is 4 times 35. So 4 can go out by 2, okay? So you can write this one again like this, okay? 2 square root what? 35. Oh, inches. That's it. Alright. Okay. All right, I have another one, so almost the same, but this time they can give you that tangent line, okay, which is the length of a tangent line first, which is in this case 8 inches. Then they can give you that big circle, maybe radius is 5 inches. Then what is the small circle radius? So that's a good question, okay? So then you can put this one like X, right? That's it. Now, also in this case, you can add another line right here, okay? So just like this, okay? That's going to be 90 degrees. Okay, another line right there, okay? So that's also 90 degrees. Just like that. Then I continue this one like this. Alright, see? Then I can make another rectangle right there. Alright, so looks good. Now this one is also 90. Okay, that's a rectangle. We have a thin triangle right there, right? So now you can make sense. Okay, this total right here is a 5. This one is a X. So this length right here, this is going to be what? Alright, that's right, 5 minus X. Okay, this is 5 minus X. How about this? Okay, total. Okay, oh, that's what actually we are looking for. But this total is X plus 5, right? Alright, this one is X plus 5 or 5 plus X. Because I have 5 minus X, so I make this one look alike, okay? This one is 8 inches. So now, oh, another Pythagorean theorem, right? Okay, so 5, okay, plus X squared equals, okay, 5 minus X squared, okay, plus 8 squared. Oh man, almost done. Okay, we gotta solve this one, right? Okay, this is 25 plus 10x plus x squared equals 25 minus 10x plus x squared plus 64. Whoa! Then, all we have to do, we just simplify this one, right? Okay, that's right. 25 goes away. Now, x squared is gone. Now I move this 10 minus 10x to your left hand side. It's going to be a plus. That's why this is going to be 20x equals 64. So, man, almost done. X equals 64 divided by 20. Whoa, man, so easy, right? 3.2. Whoa, that's it. 3.2 inches. This one right here, 3.2 inches. Hey, looks like, okay, this one is a 5, this one is a 3.2. Makes sense. That's it.